Hi friends, in this video we are going to apply a technique called as mesh analysis to solve a circuit having more than two loops. That means we can have a problem of three loops, and based on the mesh currents we are going to calculate all the branch currents in a circuit. So let's take a numerical. So two batteries are given of 7 volt and 6 volt. This value of resistance is 1 ohm. This is 2, 3 ohm, 2 ohm once again, and this is 1 ohm. The objective is to find out all loop currents and hence all branch currents. That means current flowing through this 1 ohm, 2 ohm, 3 ohm, 2 ohm and 1 ohm using mesh analysis. So here I am having 3 loops, 1, 2 and 3. So quickly I will mark loop currents I1, I2, I3. Based on the directions of I1, I2, I3, I will mark all voltage that got developed across resistances. So because of this I1, the drops are like this, plus minus for 1 ohm and this plus minus for 2 ohm. For this I2, the drops are plus minus and plus minus like this. For this third loop, because of I3, in the direction of I3, I am having drops like this. And already battery's polarities are mentioned, no need to alter that. So let's apply KVL to loop number 1. So loop 1, I will start from this point, tracing these two resistances, this battery and this battery, and will come to the same point. So in this direction I have plus minus, that is minus I1, minus plus, that is plus I2, plus minus, minus 2 I1, minus plus, plus 2 I3, and plus minus, it's a voltage drop, that is minus 6, and last element minus plus, this is plus 7 equal to 0. After simplifying this, I will get minus I1, minus 2 I1 will become minus 3 I1, plus I2 will remain as it is, plus 2 I3 will remain as it is, minus 6 plus 7 will become plus 1 equal to 0. I will take this constant to other side of equation. So finally I will get equation minus 3 I1 plus I2 plus 2 I3 equal to minus 1. This is equation number 1. Similar way I can apply KVL to loop number 2. Let's go back to the original circuit. So in this circuit I am applying KVL to loop number 2. I am starting from this point and tracing this path, I will come to that point once again. So in this direction of current I have this drop, this drop and this drop. Along with these drops I am having two voltage rises also. That means minus plus, this voltage rise, and minus plus, this voltage rise. So keeping this in mind, let's apply KVL to loop number 2. So I will have minus 2 I2 minus 3i2 plus 3i3 minus i2 plus i1 equal to 0. Since I am not having any voltage source in a loop, so that term won't be there. After simplifying this, I will get i1 as it is, minus 2 minus 3 and minus 1 i2 will become minus 6 i2 plus 3 i3 will remain as it is equal to 0, equation number 2. In similar manner, I can apply KVL to loop number 3. So let's go back to the original circuit once again. Now I am considering this loop and starting from this point and will come back to the same point after tracing this path. So number of voltage drops and rises are there. So let's write that. Minus 3i3 plus 3i2 minus i3 plus 6 minus 2i3 plus 2i1 equal to 0. Let's simplify this equation. So I will take first i1 terms, so 2i1, then i2 terms, 3i2, and i3 terms are minus 3, minus 1 and minus 2. So it will be minus 6 i3, and constant is 6. I can take to other side, it will become minus 6. So this is equation number 3. After solving equations 1, 2 and 3, I will get values of loop currents as i1 equal to 3 ampere, i2 equal to 2 ampere, and finally i3 equal to 3 ampere. Now, having these values of mesh currents, I can get all the branch currents. So let's calculate the values of all branch currents. So I will start with this resistance first. So current flowing through 1 ohm resistance, I'm talking about this 1 ohm resistance. So here I will draw a small pictorial view of this resistance, and here two currents are flowing, i1 in downward direction and i2 upward direction. Now I got the values of i1, i2 and i3 as 3 ampere, 2 ampere and 3 ampere respectively. So i1 ohm will become i1 minus i2, because different directions of currents and i1 is more than i2, so I can say 3 minus 2, which is 1 ampere, and since I am having i1 more than i2, so the resultant current will have the downward direction same as the i1. Now I will calculate the current flowing through this 2 ohm resistance. Only i2 is flowing through this 2 ohm resistance, so current flowing through 2 ohm resistance I will have same as i2, which is equal to 2 ampere, and I am getting a positive answer. So whatever direction of current I have mentioned are correct. So for this 2 ampere, it is again a downward, because if I am considering this loop current, this loop current is nothing but a branch current for this 2 ampere and flowing downward direction. Let's calculate current flowing through 3 ohm. So for 3 ohm, the resistance is given like this, this 3 ohm resistance, and here I am having two currents, one current is flowing like this, which is I2, and another current is flowing like this, which is I3. So current flowing through the 3 ohm resistance will be subtraction of these two currents. Since I3 is more than I2, I can say it's I3 minus I2, which is 3 minus 2, which is 1 ampere. And the resultant current will have the direction same as I3 because I3 is more than I2. So the direction will be like this. Let's calculate current flowing through this 1 ohm resistance. So since there is a conflict between this 1 ohm and 1 ohm, so better I will mention the node A and B. And now I have to get a current flowing through this 1 ohm resistance, which is connected between points A and B. So I will have the notation like this. It's a 1 ohm resistance connected between points A and B. Only I3 is flowing through that particular resistance. So this loop current is nothing but a branch current for this 1 ohm. So the answer will be very simple, is equal to I3. I3 is given as 3 ampere and the current direction will be downwards. Similarly, let's calculate current flowing through this 2 ohm resistance now. Again, there is a conflict between this 2 ohm and this 2 ohm. So better I will give notation as C and D. So I need to find out current flowing through the 2 ohm resistance, which is connected between points C and D. So this 2 ohm resistance is subjected to two currents. One current is I1 flowing downward and another current is I3, which is flowing upward. So obviously current flowing through 2 ohm resistance is I1 minus I3. Now coincidentally, I am having I1 and I3, both are of same value, and that is 3 ampere. So 3 minus 3, the answer is 0 ampere. So here we have seen how mesh analysis technique can be used to calculate all loop currents, and by knowing all loop currents, how we can get branch currents. In subsequent videos, we will see more numericals based on mesh analysis. Thank you.